There is no other problem as puzzling, mind-boggling, and as mysterious as consciousness. Much can be gained if we make progress in unraveling this mystery. Definitely, it will be a breakthrough for the present science. This video is an attempt to explain whether the universe is really conscious or not. Please watch the video full. Subscribe to the channel if you find it useful. Consciousness has been an enigma to researchers and philosophers right from the ancient times. Everyone knows what consciousness is, but unable to explain or define and quantify it. Scientists in general think that consciousness is a property of matter. Pure philosophical approach cannot give any solution to issues related to consciousness. In fact, the issues are beyond the frame of philosophy. According to Roger Penrose, consciousness is an interdisciplinary problem which spreads over quantum mechanics, relativity, gravity, neuroscience, mathematics, brain sciences, etc. His orchestrated objective reduction theory is considered as a quantum neuro model to explain the origin of human consciousness. Since consciousness is not tangible, it is not easy to confirm its existence experimentally. Consciousness of the universe has been a topic of interest for many researchers. Is the universe really conscious? If yes, how? Perhaps consciousness is a hidden substratum of the universe, but not yet envisioned by the present science. Recently, there were reports of a few researchers that the universe might be conscious or the universe might experience consciousness. What do such statements really mean? Here is the relevance for models for consciousness. One of the problems in research related to consciousness is to establish the correlation between brain states and mental states. According to Dr. Johannes Kleiner, a model of consciousness is a scientific theory that attempts to explain how conscious experience and the physical domain, that is, the brain states and related phenomena, are connected. Literature surveys show several types of models to explain consciousness. We find models based on empirical results from neuroscience or psychology. Models based on pure theoretical ideas are also there. The vast majority of these models are not mathematical in nature, but rather formulated in terms of ordinary scientific language. Among the various models developed so far, a model called Integrated Information Theory deserves our special attention. This model employs certain mathematical tools to analyze consciousness. Whether mathematical tools have any advantage in the study of consciousness? Are they better than non-mathematical methods? These questions are major concerns of researchers. Also, they search for characteristic features of consciousness, especially its subjective nature. They are looking for methods to incorporate the subjective nature as part of the models. Mathematical models try to explain and represent conscious experience in mathematical terms. This makes mathematical models of consciousness so powerful. One can use a mathematical space to represent the content of conscious experience. Suppose we have the mathematical description of a physical domain, for example, the neural networks in the brain. Then a model of consciousness can be applied to calculate the conscious experience related to it. Any physical system that can be represented mathematically can be plugged into a model of consciousness. Thus, the conscious experience of that system can be calculated according to that model. So, an approximate mathematical description of the universe would enable us to calculate the conscious experience of the universe. Thus, mathematical models of consciousness allow us to calculate the conscious experience of any system, say human mind, computer networks, or even the universe. But which model of consciousness describes the reality correctly is not clear to us. However, it is a possibility that the universe as a whole has some conscious experience. Integrated information theory is a mathematical model of consciousness. Its input is some mathematical description of a physical system. Output will be both the content and intensity of the system's conscious experience described in mathematical terms. In mathematical terminology, this is called a mapping from physical systems to spaces of conscious experience. Major role of integrated information theory is to define this mapping in a particular way. A computer receives signals from the network cable and converts them into text which can be read in web browser. Or rather, we can say that the computer receives information from the cables, transforms this information suitably, and then displays it in the web browser. Many a time, this may not be a straightforward process, but connecting several times to various circuits and processes. This is called recurrent processing, and a computer or brain that carries out a lot of recurrent processing is called integrated. Systems which are performing a large number of recurrent processing are strongly integrated. They exhibit a larger degree of consciousness than systems which are not doing any significant recurrent processing. To spell this out in detail, a lot of mathematical tools are required. But the above is the fundamental intuition. The more integrated a system's information processing is, the more consciousness it has. Regarding the consciousness of the universe, many scientists think that consciousness is completely determined by the physical things. According to them, consciousness plays no role in the functions of the universe. Suppose there is a conclusive evidence that consciousness played a genuine causal role in the universe. It would have several consequences for the scientific view of the world. Definitely, it would enkindle a Copernican revolution in the science of this century. In spite of the several theories already available for consciousness, certain gaps exist in its conceptual development. The existence of consciousness and its origin are to be addressed separately. Whether consciousness is an eternal reality of the universe or outcome of certain processes is to be clarified. Again, many a time, existence of consciousness as an entity and its manifestations or functions are not well distinguished. The functions of consciousness are treated sometimes equivalently to consciousness. Integrated information theory, when speaks about the origin or existence of consciousness as a property of a self-organized system which is largely integrated, a question remaining: can we design and make an integrated system which is conscious? The analysis with the mathematical models may not be realistic. For example, if we make a model for the electrical conductivity of matter, we will be able to analyze the electrical conductivity of any form of matter with the model. Any material will have a mathematical conductivity. Even dielectrics or insulators also will have some numerical value for their conductivity. But this never makes an insulator practically an electrical conductor. It is clear that analysis with the models may not be realistic and would be far away from practical realities. The same is applicable to consciousness when it is treated with mathematical models. However, I am not in a position to reject the possibility of a conscious universe outright. It need not be mere a mathematical construction. Let me conclude with another point. The universe came into existence several billions of years ago. It was a physical evolution. The universe exhibits order and rhythm in its various functions. In fact, mathematics is the language of the universe. Evolution of life happened gradually after the evolution of the physical universe as we understand. The order and discipline, of course, as well as the evolution of life forms with the consciousness, may be taken as reasons to infer that the universe might be conscious. But establishing it as a fact beyond doubt still remains as a challenge for scientists and philosophers
who are involved in interdisciplinary research.